Hi, I'm Mike, and today we're going to talk about wheel materials under construction. For most of us, when we go to select custom wheels for our vehicle, we're probably going to be looking at the design more than anything when it comes to the wheel type we want to go with. That being said, some other things we probably want to consider as well is the construction and materials that the wheels are made out of. I got four examples here of the most popular ones that we sell here at Summit. And they're probably going to fall within a range of what you're going to be looking at for your vehicle depending on your budget and the style of wheel that you want. The first one I want to talk about though is the steel wheel here, and this is probably going to be the cheapest wheel that you're going to go ahead and be able to put on your vehicle. The thing about a steel wheel is because it's made out of steel, it is going to corrode. These are not available in all the vast sizes that your aluminum wheels are probably going to be available in, and you're really just going to be limited on things like backspacing. And the other obstacle with these is on a lot of late model vehicles, if you're to go to put a steel wheel on there and it wasn't even originally equipped with a steel wheel or a steel wheel was not an option, you may have some fitment issues with the brake calipers because of the way the rim shell is designed, as well as the way that the offset of the front and back spacing of the wheel is set up. With aluminum wheels, you're probably going to come to find that there's a lot more options. And what that really has to deal with is the way that the aluminum has been formed. For most of us, we're probably going to be looking at aluminum wheels that are made out of cast aluminum, which is like this wheel right here. What we know about a casting is much like casting an engine block or whatever it may be, what you're going to have is you're going to have the aluminum that's poured into a mold. The mold's then separated and you end up with a finished product essentially that may require some fine tuning or some finish work, but for the most part, the form that it took in that mold is what you're going to end up with. The thing about cast aluminum wheels is that a casting is more porous and typically heavier because it requires more material because of that porosity to keep up that product's integrity. The other obstacle with it is that whatever way it came out of the mold or whatever molds are built, that's all you're going to have available, meaning that you're only going to have set back spacings, you're only going to have set insets as far as how deep dish the wheel looks or whatever that may be from that manufacturer, because every time they have to build a new mold, it gets more expensive to produce more of those wheels. A step up from that would be a billet aluminum wheel like this one right here. Most commonly you're going to find these through Centerline and Built Specialties through us. Billet aluminum wheels for the most part are probably the most versatile out of all aluminum wheels because they start out as one solid billet chunk, and that billet chunk is a lot more stable, meaning that there's much less porosity within the metal, it's a lot denser. And what it gives us the ability to do is it gives us the ability to go ahead and build a very strong wheel and at the same time have all kinds of different variations, meaning that we can do custom designs, we can machine it out on a CNC machine and do whatever we want with it and get any type of custom backspacing or whatever that may be. That being said, this wheel here is probably going to be double the cost of that of its cast aluminum equivalent. And then we're also going to have forged race wheels. Forged race wheels are extremely light and extremely strong, but they kind of parallel the design of cast aluminum wheels, meaning that they're going to be coming from a mold. So we have a situation here to where we have an extremely light and extremely strong wheel, and it's going to be the lightest out of the bunch by far. But at the same time, we're probably going to be limited on the back spacings that are available and the sizing that's available depending on the manufacturer that's producing them. One other wheel that's out there that I think some of us don't realize exists is a composite wheel. A composite wheel uses a steel rim shell with an aluminum insert. What this does is it gives the wheel manufacturer the ability to go ahead and build a wheel that has quite a few different offsets, different looks as far as the inset goes and the width of the lip. And how they're going to build this wheel is basically they're going to go ahead and heat up the shell structure like most wheels that are a two-piece wheel. Once they go ahead and do that, they'll go ahead and insert the aluminum in the aluminum center section that is, and then weld it to that rim shell. One last thing to consider when selecting wheels for your vehicle is the weight of the wheels that you're looking at. What you'll notice is that along with the cost, typically the more expensive the wheel gets, the lighter it gets as well. There's a reason for that. That is, the lighter the wheel is, the less rotating mass you're going to have and the less unsprung weight you're going to have. That almost always leads to better braking and better vehicle performance. Keep an eye out for our other videos on wheels and tires. Thanks for watching.